to give all the praises and the honor to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, Racha, HaKwadash, and double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone, Shalom, Labakwa, MS to the elect. And I don't know what I'll title this video. This is literally raw in the spirit. But I've been watching a couple of apostles' videos and mainly a few things about the lying and elder statuses and bald heads and shiners and fades. And, you know, you got all kinds of things going on. So when you see these things start happening, you know, you have to pay close attention. Now, the one video paying most attention to is the Apostle Gabbar's video when he went into the camp leadership, elder status, and that's where I'm going to go at, because the brothers might have heard an apostle call me an elder or whatever, but that's where you get confused. You got elders of camps, okay, where a brother might be an elder brother of a camp, but he's not an elder of the truth, or as I say, Great Millstone, okay? And there's nothing wrong with that. It's okay to be a brother. It's, you know, why would you want a position that you don't really deserve, or calling yourself something that you don't, you know, you're not on that status? Now, that you would have top elders, you would have elders that I recognize, like Springfield, and those elders I watch coming up, you know, I would never put myself on a level with them. Damn sure not an apostle, okay? But there's younger brothers here, you know, that I may perform elderly, you know, elderly duties to, okay? So, and other brothers in other camps that are elders of their camps, okay? There's a difference, okay? 1 Peter 5:6, I'll just make this quick. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of Yahweh, that he may exalt you in due time. So the Lord will exalt you. I mean, if it's meant for you to be exalted, you will. And I always say, you know, I never really cared, so to speak. I'm not saying I don't care, but it was not a big deal for me to try to be somebody that I wasn't. I don't mind. I tell everybody, I don't mind being called a brother. That's okay with me. I mean, let's say this place wraps up, you know, this year, you know, all that matters is that you are still a brother. Man, really, it matters that you are the elect. That's all that really matters at that point. Now, when you're dealing with the time stamp, so to speak, that the Lord set up, that's why a lot of guys fall out. They get bitter. They get mad. They hate apostles. They hate their leaders. They hate elders. You know, now me and Apostle Ricard talked about this. You know, in the world, you have like aged elderly men or women or whatever. You always had some form of respect as long as they respected you. Now, when you go out here into the world today, you don't see nobody respecting anybody of any kind of, you know, and really an elder of the world is nothing like an elder of the truth. I'm just making a point, because if you had respect when you was in the world to your, you know, a form of leadership, let's say on the job or your parents, then it's easier for you when you come into the truth to have respect for your spiritual parents, okay, and to follow. And that's the problem with a lot of young men that come into the truth. They don't want to follow. They want to walk beside an apostle. They want to walk beside an elder, so to speak, you know. And really, just be happy to be a brother. You know, that's my whole point of this video. There's brothers who comment, Shalom, elder, and I never really looked at it like that. But just to clear up confusion, so, you know, you can't have everybody going around calling themselves elders that are really not elders of Great Millstone. Okay, these are titles, and well-deserved titles for men who've been doing this for a very long time. Okay, this word title, looking at definition, I just have to go there. It says the distinguishing name of a written, printed, or film production. Okay. Let me get to one that best fits. A descriptive name. Okay. An appellation. Okay. Of dignity, honor, distinction. Okay. Or preeminence attached. Okay. To a person or family by virtue of rank, office, precedent, privilege, attainment, or land. So these are titles, okay? And if you haven't earned the title of a particular group and you're calling yourself that title, then you're not honoring the Most High, okay? You're not honoring the Most High, because that's what you're supposed to do. Honor Yahweh, okay? And Yahweh Shah, okay? And that word appellation, let's hear it. I don't know exactly how to pronounce it.
Appellation.
Okay, that's appellation. I didn't know they had to speak on here. Okay, appellation. Okay, identifying a name or title, a designation. Okay, and that's pretty much it. Okay, it's all about, I just want to clear that up. So if anybody's calling me, an elder, and I remember I talked to some years back. I talked to one of the elders. I'm not going to say his name, and I called him an apostle. And he stood up like, man, don't be calling me no apostle, man. You know, so that's full. When you are in the spirit of full order, you can't go wrong, man. Okay, you can't go wrong. There's nothing wrong with being in order. Also, let me say this. You have these men that's been doing this 30 plus years, 20-some years, or whatever the case. They are men of age for a reason, okay? Now, you might say back in the scriptures, okay, is you know everybody grew up, some knew who they was Israelites, you know, from birth. But you're living in a time now where you're in Babylon, Sodom of Egypt. You're in the Greco-Roman Empire. You're in the Assyrians. You're in all the wicked empires rolled up in one. And this is why the scriptures speak of men watching over the flock, watching over your souls. So, you know, as the torch is being passed down, each one of us are responsible, okay, for the next man coming in, as they are responsible for us. And so it's just the way it's set up. And as I've seen it, and I'll say this again, I've witnessed guys, some younger guys even come in, and in their minds believe that the Lord gave them the truth, and they haven't even learned or been tested or even understand life at this point. You know, they haven't even experienced, gotten through the testing of life in Babylon, let alone in the truth. Okay. I've seen it, you know, and I've seen the bug outs. Hell, I've been in my worldly profession almost 30 years as of today. And I'd be damned if somebody's going to come in 4 years and going to walk beside me and tell me that what the hell I'm doing wrong. And they haven't been tested on how to do the job for them, their damn self. Okay. That's all I have on that. Shalom.